Right, so today's tasks are a few. The major one is take off that long bar goes across. This is where the brake servo is attached with the master cylinder, because it's a right-hand drive model. The pedals are on the other side. There's that tube and there's this rod here go inside, so with the time it just gets stiffer and stiffer and stiffer, and at some point the pedal is like a tractor heavy, lazy. I mean, when you press the brake pedal and when you take your foot off, it just comes very very slowly. This one is very very bad. I had to take off the exhaust manifold. I'm doing in the meantime the subframe. So that was really, really easy because the subframe was off the car anyway, and it's a great access underneath exhaust as well. So I dropped that. There was a rubber cover here. That one, pretty much, you cannot take this off if you don't take the exhaust manifold off. So that's a hell of a job. So, but before I actually reach this rubber thing, you have this exhaust heat shield. This heat shield actually is attached to the chassis, and there's another heat shield which is attached to that heat shield. This is attached to the exhaust manifold. So we have those two. We have that one, and that's why we have to take off the exhaust manifold completely to gain access to that tube here. To take off that tube for the brakes. These two hoses, these two pipes are on the way. The two hoses for the heater matrix as well, they're out. This for the heater for the cabin, so they're out already. So that's the next job. Take off there four bolts on this end, and there two bolts here and there, and I'll be able to pull out that tube. But before that, I have to take off also that rubber cover. It's held by five nuts. These are M6 bolts. Whoa! So that's the tube out. You could see it in all its glory. So this thing here, nothing much in it. There's a pivot point somewhere. So when you break the brake pedal, dust is just going like that. It's so stiff. Actually, seems like the problem is that bush here, bush or whatever it is. It's so stiff, I struggle. To pull and push, that's really hard. So the spring on the brake servo definitely is not strong enough to push back. When you take the foot off the pedal, so that's why when you take off your foot, this thing is going very 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 slow. And never to the max, never. I had that problem last year, so what I did was it was a bit of a dodgy repair, but I had that extra spring under the steering wheel attached to the brake pedal, so it was helping the brake servo spring to bring the pedal back up when you take off your foot. So, but that spring was a bit too stiff, plus it's an extra spring that it's supposed not to be in the system, and the feel of the brake pedal was like a tractor pedal. It was really stiff. So yeah, and I also have a new master cylinder to replace. This is the old one. There was nothing wrong with that one, to be honest. No leaks, don't know, but strike a good deal for a brand new one. So I think that's the one. Yes. So this is the replacement. Again, it's the original OEM part. So that goes in as well. And the brakes should be like a new car. Right, let's get on with that bush and see is it serviceable or anything we could do, or just need a good clean. Okay, so I just want to show you how stiff this bush here is. That bush, I have that pull scale balancer, whatever it is, so it measures in a kilos. So watch how many kilos the brake servo spring had to overtake. So that's 4, 5, 5½, 6, 6½, 7. Almost 8 kilos. 8 kilos. So it's roughly 16-17 pound. 16-17 pound. 8 kilos. 8 kilos for that spring. Where's the brake zero? So that spring has to overtake those 7 kilos, and also the spring in the master cylinder as well. So that's simply crazy. So that's the offender. This is I'm yet to discover, but seems like just a bush. But the thing is that when I slacken the bolt goes like so. So when I slacken the bolt, this immediately start to spin easier, like almost normal. So I'll guess, as you would imagine, this thing stays here like so. So when you tension the bolt, it just squeeze the frame against the bush, and that's why it makes it so hard. So either it was always too tight, either this is meant to pivot here, so the bolt keeps top and bottom part squeezed tight. The actual pivot point will be here, so I don't know. I'll try to take this apart and we'll see. Right, I took off the center pin of that bush. I don't know, I can't say that it was meant to be like that, but seems like it's spinning around the bolt. So what I did is just clean this up here and grease the surface here on the top as well, and put grease here and here. This is a waterproof grease. It's meant to be used for a marine, so it should be good for 10 years at least here. I mean, there's no water, anything goes in, so it should be fine. That's it, all back in. See, it's just effortless now. I was struggling with two fingers to pull that in the beginning, and now it's just really smooth. No dragging at all, there's no play, just perfect. So one thing sorted, so I have to put back the whole lot, and that's the rod that goes inside that tube. So it's all assembled back one piece. You could see how effortless it moves now. Just barely touch it, so as it should be. One job done. On to the next.